The time I'm going to the way I'm going to use my time in the upcoming weeks is, of course, to make the team in the best possible way and the players in the best possible way, for us to be ready for the first game. And it always helps if you get to know the city, but I think as a manager, and everybody knows, it helps even more if you win most of your games. So I think with Jurgen, it was a combination of getting to know the city, getting to know the style of play the fans like, and. I don't want to take words out of Richard's mouth, but I think one of the reasons why he came to me was that our playing style is not so much different. So we both like the fans to come into the stadium and see a team that plays with a lot of energy, that plays good football, and I think that is the thing I'm focused on most. And if we do that in the best possible way, that probably will give me some time as well. And if I have time, I can then get to know the city a bit better. But it all starts with improving the team and winning as many games as we can.
Julie?
Hi, Julia from BBC Radio Merseyside. Last season, due to a lot of injuries with senior players, we saw a lot of the younger members in the squad being used by Jurgen, and they certainly stood up and were counted when was needed. Are you someone that likes seeing that, working with the younger members of the squad, bringing them through, and will they have that same opportunity this season to play?
I like to see good players, and if they're old or young, that doesn't matter that much, but it's always nice for a club and also nice for a team that young players come through the ranks. I think that's the way to, the right words to use. So that always gives energy into a club as well, so that they're not only the players that are brought in from other clubs, but also the players from the academy. So, but in the end, it's all about the quality. And I agree with you, they did really well. So if they continue doing so, there will be a fair chance that they will play as well.
What would be the things you'll be focusing on first while being at this club, football-wise? What are the things you want to focus on when you're still in the team first?
Getting to know the people that work here, which I've done already, of course. Getting to know the players, especially as a person, but mainly as a player, because I've seen a lot of games from them. I've seen a lot of training sessions, but I think you get to know them even better if you are there with them together, and then implement playing style. But it's not that we're going to change everything over here, because a lot of things are done really well. But we have to find ways to improve. And I took my time for that, because I was off for a lot of weeks, so I had a lot of time to look where we can improve. But I think starting to work with them will actually get us an even better insight in the improvements we have to make.
James? James Pearce from The Athletic. Just as a head coach as opposed to manager, how do you understand the dynamic, how it's going to work with transfers in terms of your input and influence on that?
For me, it's not a change, as you might know, because in Europe we work like this, and I've worked at Feyenoord and my former clubs like this always. I think there are not many clubs in the world, maybe there are not even clubs in the world, where there's one person that decides everything. So it's a calibration, is that the right word to use? Calibration between people. I don't think there were many sports directors that bring players in that the manager or the head coach doesn't like, and it's the other way around. So but it's not only the two of us. I think at a club like this, there are many more people that can bring in their opinion. And that's the way I've worked recent years. And I like to work like this, to be honest.
Some people would have been put off by the prospect of trying to follow in the footsteps of such an iconic figure. Was that something you had to mull over? Or is that just your self-belief you wanted to take this on?
No, not at all, actually. I think you can look at it both ways. You can look at it, yeah, there are big shoes to fill, but you can also look at it in a way that you inherit a squad and a team that has a winning culture. And one of the reasons to come here, and there are always more reasons for this, but one of the reasons is that I do feel we have a real good team, real good squad. And I think as a manager, you want to work at a club where there are good players with the opportunity to win something. And the past has shown that there is a possibility for Liverpool to win some trophies. So, yeah, I think it's, you can look at it a way to be the successor of someone who's really successful, but that's maybe, I look at it in a way that that is ideal, because there is an opportunity to win something, and I like to work with players, I like to develop them, but I like to win as well, and there's an opportunity at this club to win, so.
Hi, I'm David from ITV. I think Jurgen Klopp had the fans singing your name to the final game. It was just spoken with him. Was there one piece of advice or one thing that he said to you about the club, about this role, that has stood out to you?
Oh, we've spoken about many things, but I think it's not more than normal that the things we've spoken about that stays between us. So him singing a song for me was special, because I don't think many... there are not many managers where the fans sing for. Is that maybe not the best English to use, but I was fortunate enough that after a few years at Feyenoord, they start to sing for me. But now coming over here without even worked here yet, without winning a game, already fans singing for you, that's a good start.
Was it Jurgen's rivalry with Pep Guardiola really encapsulated, really kind of grossed the Premier League? How much are you looking forward to that challenge as well, to the one likes of that?
Something to look forward to, but I think there are many more good managers in this league, which is normal, because English people like to believe that's the best league in the world, and I believe this as well. So it's normal that if you work at it's such a league, there are many good managers where you have to which you're going to face, and Pep is one of them, that's for sure. And I think it was last time when I had the interviews with Liverpool. I'm lucky enough that I lived in an era where I could see the Barcelona team. It's one thing we have in common. But when he left, when Pep left over there, there came a new era, and that was the rivalry between Liverpool and City. So I've seen a lot of that rivalry and a lot of games of both teams. I'm looking forward to work here, but not specifically playing against Man City, because there are many nice teams we're going to face, starting with Ipswich, of course, which is at this moment the most important one.
Hey, good morning, both. Richard, a question for you. Could you just explain the criteria used to pick Arne? I know he's mentioned the play style as the physical basis for that, and what are the elements that fans should be looking out for?
Yeah, so that philosophy, that playing style that attracted us to Arne, is based on subjective footballing opinion and data as well, as you'd expect. And in all the metrics, Arne's Feyenoord team came out really well. The way they played with a real front foot attacking football, played with intelligence, played with passion. And I think those are all attributes that we would welcome here at Liverpool. I think they lend really well with the current squad that we have, our supporters and the football club as a whole.
Do you believe that this playing style is the best playing style there is? So for example, Van's own style, Sean Dyche's own style.
Yeah, I think it depends on the situations that you have. I think it depends on the players that you have, the players that you would like to recruit. I think this way of playing, this style of playing that Arne has obviously been very successful with is the most attractive to watch, in my opinion. But I believe it will be so in the opinion of the football fans, and that's the most important thing. I think there is a duty here to play that type of football where you're trying to grab games by the scruff of the neck. And I don't think that's every Liverpool team that I've seen in recent memory has done that. As Arne said, it's not going to be a hugely different approach and style to what has been so successful in the foreseeable past. And we hope to emulate that again.
Hi,
this is Colin of the Netherlands. Good to see you here, Arne. You've already spoken to the captain, Virgil van Dijk, and presumably also Mo Salah. Can you tell us anything about the desire and hunger you felt in these conversations for them to keep performing in Liverpool and keep winning trophies here?
I think in general, every top player wants to win. And I assume, and I'm hoping, Virgil first wants to win the Euros. maybe not everything is in one line in their area. And then when he comes back after he enjoyed a few days of his holidays, he will come back, and all these players want to win. And they have the hunger to win. If you don't have that, you're not playing for a club like Liverpool. So
you have the hunger to stay at Liverpool as well.
I did, yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Did you tell Cody Gakpo to slow down at the Euros?
No, I'm hoping he will step up a bit even more, especially in the semi-final. First quarterfinals. Yeah, hoping to see them playing the England national team in the semifinals. Yeah. So we are hoping and expecting them to do even better. Cody has a very good tournament. Like his last one, the World Cup was really good for him as well. He's been impressive till now, and I can only hope for him that he can continue doing so in the upcoming games.
I'm a Sandstone BBC. Just going back to James's point on following someone like Jurgen Klopp, do you have to think about what you're going to say to the players? Because there's something unquantifiable about a manager who's been in charge for so long that the voice and the messaging is consistent and the demands are the same. You've got to go in and impress those players as well.
Yeah, but that's a general feeling. That has nothing to do with who've worked here before. I think as a manager, you go to bed at night and you think about what you're going to do and what you're going to tell the players every day. That's not only before your first day. That's during your whole period where you work. So it's people tend to look at us and think we're only thinking about the tactic board, which we do a lot as well. But it's also about convincing players and the way to talk to them. So for me, that has nothing to do with being the successor of Jurgen. That is something that's part of the job, that you think about, okay, how can I get the best out of the players? What way do I have to approach them as an individual or as a team? So for me, that's not something I have Jurgen in mind. What would he say? No, that's not the way I look at it. But it is, okay, I get to know the players, which is the best way to approach them and get the maximum and the best out of them.
And Richard, could I just ask you, you mentioned before about the players and the contracts. In general, it's been very quiet in the Premier League in transfer terms, apart from that flurry of activity at the back end of last week, which Liverpool seemed to end up getting involved with by someone offering you a player. Do you think that will change as we get nearer the transfer window deadline? Or do you think there is not a lot of money for any team at the moment?
It's hard to say and speak industry-wide. I think naturally when there are major competitions during the summer, a World Cup or a European Championships, in this case it's a Copa America and the Olympics as well. So there's a lot of football being played, and naturally the attention is going to be there. And I think that after the flurry that there was in June, I think it'll calm down a little bit now, would be my prediction for the month of July. And then like always, when August starts and coaches have had more time to work with players, I think then the opinions will be more set, I think, at football clubs. And then you may see a situation in August, which is like in previous seasons, there's a little bit of a hurry to get things done and to make sure that everyone's squads are in order. I don't think this will be any different. Who knows what will transpire economically? It's hard to say and speak for other clubs, but that was probably the case in June and why situations accrued as they did. But I'd see a quiet July and perhaps a crescendo in August would probably await us all.
John? Sorry. It's John Gibbons from the Anfield app. I'm just wondering whether you've been to Anfield yet and how much of a factor the idea of managing in front of the Anfield crowd was in your decision to come to Liverpool.
I've been there twice. Once as a fan, and once when they showed me not only this training facility but also the stadium. One of the reasons to join Feyenoord was that I think my playing style, the way I would like my teams to play, it's nice if you have the fans that appreciate that style and they are special in the league in Holland. So everybody would tell you that the Feyenoord fans are they bring more energy to the team than every other fans do. And this is what's been told to me about the Liverpool fans as well. Not only told to me, I think if you watch a lot of football, and I've been there once myself, I also felt what it means for the fans to see the team playing. So it's a win-win situation, a very good team to work with, but implementing a playing style that is going to be similar, but a bit different as well. That will lead to a lot of enthusiasm by the fans, and if that's going to be a good cooperation, the two of them, then hopefully it will lead to special things.
Thank you.
Chris.
Chris May, Jack Redman TV. I speak to fans every single day, and the dominating conversation right now is your preferred system. Obviously, we've seen it Feyenoord a lot, 4-2-3-1, and Liverpool we're accustomed to seeing it 4-3-3. Is the formation and the system something that's a non-negotiable of your ideology, or will you look at your players and tailor your system to the players at your disposal?
I'm a bit sad, is maybe not the right word, but I was hoping if people looked at my team, they would not say it's 4-2-3-1 or it's 4-3-3 or it's whatever formation you want to call it. I was hoping they would say, okay, there's a lot of freedom when they have the ball to take in different positions. So sometimes it's a 4-2-3-1, sometimes it's a 4-1-4-1, sometimes we do build up with three. So there's a lot of freedom when we have the ball. But if we don't have the ball, there's not so much freedom. Then we want to be really aggressive, and there's only one way, and that's everybody is mostly keeps his position. So I wouldn't put myself in a situation where I say I prefer 4-2-3-1 or 4-3-3 or 4-1-4-1. There's a lot of players taking in a lot of different positions. So if you would have asked me, I would have said we play 4-3-3 instead of 4-2-3-1 at Feyenoord. But we did build up a lot of times with three. Fullbacks have different roles, so I'm curious who told you that we've played 4-2-3-1. Maybe that one should go to get his license or analyze a bit better.
David Lynch, hi. I just wonder if you can tell us a little bit about backroom staff together and what they will bring to the table, and if there's any scope for further additions to that as well, maybe.
I think what has been announced already is Sipke Hulshof, who I've worked with at Feyenoord and at our former club Cambuur Leeuwarden as well. So he's sitting here in the room as well, like you probably saw. That's been announced already. Goalkeeping coach has been announced. Haven't worked with him, but we've spoken to him, the two of us, and we're really happy that he's going to join our team. And we're expecting two others to join us. Or can we...
More announcements to come.
More announcements to come. In the near future. Yes. Yeah.
Will.
Yeah, Will for Richard, I was just wondering what's chat we had with the owners then since you come in, what's been the expectations set for yourself, and how much are you looking forward to work with Michael Edwards again? Obviously, you know him from your time at Portsmouth, you've kept in touch since.
Yeah, very much looking forward to working with Michael. In my opinion, the best British sporting director to date. So the decision to come to Liverpool was obviously a one that I was humbled by and delighted to take, but it was the people that I'd be working with as well made it extra special. Conversations, again, daily at the minute. They have been from quite a way out because there was a fair bit to do to hit the ground running, of course, with on his appointment being the most important thing to do, to get right. And since then, it's been a little bit more sort of, again, like with Arne, logistics and conversations that are forward planning. But yeah, very much looking forward to working with Michael and the ownership group as a whole.
Julia?
Arne, Julia from Sky Sports. I was just wondering, when communication was first made, the contact was first made with you, what to rewind to that time, what that emotion, what that feeling was like with the ambition that you have as a head coach to bring you to Liverpool, and maybe was there a nervous excitement that everything would go to plan to bring you here?
I've worked at a real special club at Feyenoord, and I wouldn't leave that club for many clubs, but when Liverpool comes along, that was obviously one of the clubs where I would leave Feyenoord for, since you're seeing me here. But for me, maybe even more important is the first time Richard came over, that to hear the reasons why he wanted to take me, he wanted Liverpool to bring me in, and since then I've noticed how professional this club is. So it went quite fast afterwards, but most important, I think, especially for me at least, is that to get to know the reasons why they want you, because of course. We, because Sipke was involved in that as well, we were lucky enough to win a few things. But the playing style, if someone wants to convince me, he should talk to me about I like your playing style, because otherwise I would have been a wrong fit for this club or for any other club that doesn't like my playing style. So he really knew a lot. He's seen a lot. He saw a lot of games, and I think this is something you want to hear, that they don't only want you because maybe you won the league last season or won the cup this season, but it has to be more than that. And I was impressed by that. And then since then things went quite smoothly, due to my agent as well.
Hey Anne, you've spoken about already the quality of the squad you've inherited, but then also the need to improve. It's a question for both of you.
Sure.
How much activity then do you think you'll need to do this summer to continue that improvement in terms of transfers? So do you have an idea of the scale of what needs to be done this summer?
No, not in specific numbers. If you meant that, so for me, it's clear that we've inherited a squad that's a good team. There've been a few changes last season already, and I think if the way I look at football, I can see now during the Euros how important it is to work on a daily basis for a longer time with a team, because in my opinion, you see many real good players. Not all of them have the same level as they have at their clubs. So that proves my point, how important it is to work in a daily basis with your players and get the best out of them. And that's something we're going to do. There's already a real good team. Like like I just said, there have been a few new signings last season. So the longer a team plays together, if there's a good manager or a good head coach, normally you will see that things will improve. So that's why I'm fortunate that I'm going to a club where normally not many transfers go out. So I've worked at Feyenoord. It was almost normal that 8, 9, 10 players left the club after every season. So it's more difficult for a manager then to get this progress. But here I'm expecting him to keep the most of our players. and I think he wants it himself. And from there on, we can only build.
Hi, Arne. Dear Squires, Liverpool Echo. Over here during the Euros, there's obviously been plenty of debate about Trent's best position, whether he should be a defender or a midfielder. I'm sure in the Netherlands you'll get the same with Cody Gakpo, whether he should be a striker or a left winger. We've seen them in very specific